أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم Dear students, السلام عليكم I am Dr. Azhar Ali, Assistant Professor, Electrical Engineering Department, Sarhad University, Peshawar. Dear student, today's lecture is the continuation of my previous lecture. In the previous lecture, we have learned about introduction to sets. And today, we are going to learn about operations on sets. And this is the second lecture of third week for the course Mathematics 2. Operation on sets. The first operation here is a union. What is union of two sets? The union of two sets A and B is the set containing those elements which are elements of A or elements of B or both. And we can write A union B. For example, A is a set containing elements 3, 4 and 6. B is another set containing the elements 1, 2, 3, 5 and 6. Then the union of A and B will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Since the union of these two sets containing those elements which are elements of A or elements of B or elements of both sets A and B. So the union A union B contain the elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Now intersection of two sets. What is the intersection of two sets? The intersection of two sets A and B is the set containing those elements which are elements of A and elements of B. And we write A intersection B. For example, if A contains the element 3, 4, 6 and 8 and set B contains the element 1, 2, 3, 5 and 6, then intersection of A and B contain the element 3 and 6. Since 3 and 6 are common elements of both these two sets, so A intersection B contains the element 3 and 6. Now, another example, if A is a set of prime numbers and B is a set of even numbers, then A intersection B contain only one element 2, because 2 is a prime number and also an even number. So in this case, the intersection of these two sets contain only one element 2. Now another example, if A is a set of all element x such that x is greater than 5 and B is another set of all element x such that x less than 3, then there is no common element in these two statements, because A contain all elements x such that x greater than 5 and B contains those elements which are less than 3. So in this case, the intersection of these two sets will be empty. Now what are disjoint sets? Two sets A and B are said to be disjoint if they have no common element, that is A intersection B is equal to empty set. For example, this is a set A which contains the element 2, 4, 6 and 8, and B contains the element 1, 3, 5 and 7. Since there is no common element between A and B, so the intersection of these two sets will be empty sets. There is no common element in the sets A and B, so the intersection of the two sets will be empty set. So in this case, A and B, sets A and B are called disjoint sets. If A and B are not disjoint sets, A and B have some common elements, then A and B are said to be intersecting sets, are called overlapping sets. Now, the difference of two sets. If A and B are two sets, then their difference A minus B is the set containing exactly those elements in A that are not in B. For example, if A is a set containing the element A, B and C, and B is another set which containing the element A and D, then A minus B will be equal to B comma C. Similarly, B minus A contain only one element D. Now, what is a Venn diagram? A diagram that consists of circles. The inner part of circles represent the elements of the sets, and the outer parts represent elements that are not part of the set. In Venn diagram, we represent sets by circles. A Venn diagram is used to organize a list of data. Again, I want to repeat. In Venn diagram, we represent sets by a circle and represent the universal set by a rectangular shape. So, the history of Venn diagram. Venn diagram were introduced around 1880 by John Venn. They are used to teach elementary set theory. Set theory is the branch of mathematics that studies sets. It is also used to illustrate simple set relationship in probability, logic, statistics, and computer science, etc. These are the part of Venn diagram. For example, we have two sets A and B. So we represent set A by a circle and set B also represent by a circle. If A intersection B have some common elements, then this area represent the common elements and this area represent the element of A which are not common with B, and this area represent the element of B which are not common with A. This is a whole area represent the A union B, and this area represent neither A or B. So neither A or B, neither A or B, but this is a whole area represent A union B. This area only represent A intersection B, and this area represent those element of A which are not common in B, and this area represent the element of B which are not common in A. Similarly, another representation for A union B and A intersection B. This circle represent set A, and this circle represent set B. This circle represent set A, and this circle represent set B. This area represent the area of A intersection B. This area contain those elements which are common in A and B. And this area contain those elements of A which are not common in B. And this area contain those elements of B which are not common with set A. And this whole area represent A union B. This whole area represent A in B. Now, for example, how to present the union of two sets and intersection of two sets. For example, we have a set A containing the element 3, 4, 6 and 8, and another set B containing the elements 1, 2, 3, 5 and 6. Then the union of these two sets will be 1, 2, 3, 5, 6 or 8. And the union of these two sets contain the elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 8. And the intersection of these two sets contain the element 3 and 6. Now, how to represent this union of two sets and intersection of these two sets by Venn diagram? First of all, represent set A by a circle, and here A represent by a red circle and B is represented by the blue circle. this is set B and this is set A, and this purple area represent the intersection of these two sets. Now since A contain the element 3, 4, 6, 8 and B contain the element 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, so since there are two elements common in A and B, 3 and 6, so this is the area for the elements 3 and 6, and the other elements of set B, the other element of set B is 1, 2 and 5. So this circle represent set A, and this circle represent set B, and this circle represent set A. The red color represent circle set A, and the blue color represent set B. So 3 and 6 are the common elements in these two sets. So this area represent the element 3 and 6, and other elements of set B is 1, 2 and 5. Similarly, for set A, the other elements of set A are 4 and 8. This area represent A intersection B, and the whole area represent A union B. So the purple color region illustrate the intersection, and the union consists of all points which are colored red or blue or purple. Now some properties on sets mean laws on sets. The first law of union and intersection, with this commutative law of union and intersection. Commutative law of union for two sets can be written as A union B is equal to B union A. Now commutative law of two sets with respect to intersection can be written as A intersection B is equal to B intersection A. Now associative law of sets with respect to union and intersection. Associative law of three sets with respect to union, for three sets A, B and C, associative law with respect to union can be written as A union B into union C is equal to A union into B union C. And associative law with respect to intersection can be written as A intersection B into C is equal to B intersection into A intersection C. Now next law is a idempotent law. In the idempotent law, A union A is equal to A, and A intersection A is equal to A. And identity law. Identity law says that A union empty set is equal to A, and A union universal set is equal to universal set. Similarly, A intersection universal set is equal to A. Now complement law. In the complement law, A union A complement is equal to U, where U is the universal set, where A complement can be written as universal set minus A, and the complement of universal set can be written as universal set minus universal set. So in the result we get empty set. Now distributive laws. Distributive law of intersection over union for three sets A, B and C can be written as A intersection into B union C is equal to A intersection B union A intersection C. Similarly, the distributive law of union intersection for three sets A, B and C can be written as A union into B intersection C is equal to A union B intersection A union C. Now the most popular laws called De Morgan laws. There are two De Morgan laws. First law is A union B whole complement is equal to A complement intersection B complement. And the second law is about intersection. A intersection B whole complement is equal to A complement union B complement. Now, how to prove these two laws? For the proof of first law of De Morgan, let we consider two sets A and B. The first law of De Morgan say that complement of the union of two sets equal to the intersection of the complements of that two sets. That is, A union B whole complement is equal to A complement intersection B complement. Let X be an arbitrary element of P, where P is equal to A union B whole complement. Then X belong to P, mean X belong to A union B whole complement. Since X belong to A union B whole complement, so this implies that X does not belong to A union B. Since X does not belong to A union B, so X does not belong to A and X does not belong to B. Since X does not belong to A, so X belong to A complement, and X does not belong to B mean X belong to B complement. So this implies that X belong to A complement and X belong to B complement. So since here we consider X belong to A union B whole complement, and in this last step X belong to A intersection A complement intersection B complement, so A union B whole complement is equal to A complement intersection B complement. Now, how to verify this law? By an example. Let's move on example. Suppose we have universal set U contain the element 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and A is another set contain the element 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and B is another set contain the element 2, 4, 6. We want to prove the De Morgan first law, A union B whole complement is equal to A complement intersection B complement. First of all, for the left hand side, find A union B. A union B will be equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Since A union B contains elements of A or elements of B or elements of both, so the A union B is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Now, to find the complement of A union B, the complement of A union B is equal to universal set minus A union B. Subtract A union B set from the universal set, we get 7, 8, 9 and 10. So A union B whole complement contains the element 7, 8, 9 and 10. Now for the right hand side, first of all find A complement. A complement mean universal set minus A. The difference of universal set and A. Subtract set A from the universal set, we get 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. And B complement mean subtract set B from the universal set. So B complement contain the elements 1, 3, 5, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So for the right hand side, find A complement intersection B complement. A complement intersection B complement will be equal to 7, 8, 9 and 10. Since the result of A union B whole complement is a 7, 8, 9 and 10, and the result of A complement intersection B complement also contains element 7, 8, 9 and 10, so we can say that A union B whole complement is equal to A complement intersection B complement. Now to prove De Morgan second law. The De Morgan second law says that complement of the intersection of two sets equal to the union of the complement of that two sets. That is, A intersection B whole complement is equal to A complement union B complement. Let an arbitrary element X belong to A intersection B whole complement. Since X belong to A intersection B whole complement, so we can say that X does not belong to A intersection B. And when X does not belong to A intersection B, then X does not belong to A or X does not belong to B. Now, since X does not belong to A, then X belong to A complement, and X does not belong to B means X belong to B complement. So X belong to A complement union B complement. So A intersection B whole complement is equal to A complement union B complement. Since X is the element of A intersection B whole complement, and here we prove that X is the element of A complement union B complement. Dear students, note that replace AND symbol by like this. Like in this proof, I want to tell you, like in this proof, replace the R symbol, replace the R symbol by union, and replace AND by intersection. Replace AND by intersection symbol and replace the R by U symbol, by union symbol. So X belong to A complement or X belong to B complement, we can write X belong to A complement union B complement. So A intersection B whole complement is equal to A complement union B complement. I want to repeat, since X is the element of A intersection B whole complement, and here we prove that X is the element of A complement union B complement. So A intersection B whole complement is equal to A complement union B complement. Now let's move on example to prove the second law with an example. Let this is the universal set contain the element 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 up to 10, and A is another set contain the elements 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. B is another set contain the element 2, 4 and 6. Then we want to show that De Morgan's second law, A intersection B whole complement is equal to A complement union B complement. For the proof, consider left hand side. And for the left hand side, first of all, find A intersection B. So the A intersection B of these two sets is 2 and 4. Since there are two common elements between sets A and set B, which are 2 and 4, so the intersection of A and B is equal to 2 comma 4. Now to find the complement of A intersection B set, the complement of A intersection B sets means universal set minus A intersection B. Subtract this A intersection B from the universal set. Cancel these two elements 2 and 4 from the universal set and write the result of remaining elements 1, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this is the A intersection B whole complement set. Now for the right hand side, first of all, find A complement. A complement means subtract A set from the universal set. This is set A and this is the universal set. Cancel all these elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 from the universal sets, and the remaining elements are 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So A complement set contain these elements 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Similarly, for the complement of B, subtract B set from the universal set. Since B contain 2, 4 and 6, so skip these three elements 2, 4 and 6 from the universal set, and the remaining elements are 1, 3, 5, 7, 8, 9, 10. So the result of B complement contain the elements 1, 3, 5, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So the union of A complement in B complement will be equal to 1, 3, 5, 7, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Since A intersection B whole complement contains the element 1, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10, and A complement union B complement also contains these element 1, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So we can say that A intersection B whole complement is equal to A complement union B complement. And this is the end of this segment. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.